guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. For those that do not know me, my name is Sasha Garcia. If you're new around here, welcome. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and do that so you don't miss out any of my videos. And make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Today's video, we're going to be doing like a glowy bronzy look, like with the glowy skin, because, as you guys know, the Sephora sale went on a couple of weeks ago, so I took advantage. I wanted to try the Charlotte Tilbury foundation. I've heard really good things about it, and I also decided to try the Charlotte Tilbury the flawless filter. So this is like a primer, but it's not, it's hard to say, but yeah, this is gonna give you like a luminous like glow. So we're gonna mix these two, but I do have another couple of like products to help our skin look glowy. As you guys see, I look a little glowy myself because I already prepped my skin, but we'll go into that soon and I'll tell you guys what products I use and what we're gonna be using. So make sure you keep on watching and let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna give you guys like a little rundown of the products that I use to prep my skin. You guys know I prep my skin in a specific way. If you've watched my skin prep video, you would know. If not, I'm gonna link it down below just in case. But with the sale, I also took advantage and I had already tried the Ulla Henriksen products, like the banana eye cream, and I loved it. But I had never tried the moisturizer, which is like the gel cream. So these products, they're known for containing vitamin C, and you guys know I love my vitamin C. So yeah, I tried these two. I bought like a little set that brought the cream, the gel cream, the brightening eye cream, and the serum. But the serum and the eye cream are smaller, so this comes normal size and then the other two are smaller. That's fine because I know how this works, so eventually I'll just get a normal size. But yeah, I had never tried the serum. So I'm happy with that. So yeah, so today I used these two to prep my skin. And yeah, that was basically it for eye cream and the moisturizer. But since we do want a luminous skin, I'm gonna add a facial oil because I want our skin to be glowy. So what we're gonna do is, I've had on the moisturizer and the gel cream and the eye cream on for a while. So remember, it's very important for the products to soak up on your skin. So this has already been on my face for a while. So we're gonna apply a facial oil and putting on a lot here, but we want to achieve that glowy look. We're going to use the MAC Stroke Cream. This gives you a little bit of a luminous finish too. And I'm thinking about maybe throwing in a bit of the Iconic London Illuminator Drops, just a little bit though, because this goes a long way. So yeah, we're going to work with that. And then from there, we'll put on the rest of the products. But I don't want to put too much though. This sounds like a lot, but this is gonna work, you'll see. So we're gonna start with the facial oil. This one is from Elemis. It's the Pro Collagen Rose Facial Oil. So yeah, like I was saying, a little tip is I always try to keep a Kleenex or like a makeup wipe near me so that as I'm doing the steps, like if my hands get dirty, cause yeah, applying a lot of products with their hands sometimes and they tend to get dirty with makeup. So to avoid it going everywhere and like maybe, I don't know, applying it in the wrong place, like transferring, I always keep a little Kleenex or a makeup wipe so that I can clean my hands. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna start with the facial oil. We're just gonna apply, I'm gonna apply a little bit because I don't wanna apply too much. We're gonna do like two drops. So I did three actually. So I'm gonna rub that in and I'm gonna work it on my skin, tap it on. As you guys saw, it wasn't that much, so we're not gonna be like extra oily. So we're gonna go ahead and make sure we close this up because I don't want any accidents, because it already happened to me. I spilled like almost half of the bottle. That's how I was recording the tutorial, but it's okay. And like I told you guys, I do wanna go in with the MAC Stroke Cream. So this is the Hydrating Stroke Cream from MAC, and this is in the shade Gold Light. They do have more shades, I believe, but I like this one best. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to be adding it to a mixing palette. You can get these off Amazon, They're pretty affordable. You don't need them. You can do it on the back of your hand. I personally don't like getting so many products on my, I don't like working so much on my hand. I don't know. Sometimes, but I try not to. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and mix it here. And I have my mixing little stick. Okay, I'm gonna start with that much. I think that's fine. Shake this up. And this, you guys saw, this is very humid, so I'm not gonna add too much. I'm gonna add one drop. Okay, that's it. So, look something like this. And I'm mixing it up, okay? And I'm going in with this dual fiber brush from Luxie. This is the 516. I'm gonna apply it all over my skin. Okay, so that's been sitting on our skin for a while. You guys can't see it, but I did let it sit on my skin for a while. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna move to our foundation. And we'll, the star of the video today. So I'm gonna go ahead and with the Flawless Filter first, and then I'm gonna move on to the foundation. So they come in different shades for the Flawless Filter. So for the Hollywood Flawless Filter, so I got 4 medium. And for the foundation, I chose the 6 neutral. So I bought this directly off the Sephora page, and what I like about the Sephora page is that they have the shade finder. So with the shade finder, it's easier for you to find your foundation. So sometimes it'll give you like the exact shade match, and sometimes it'll give you something similar. I don't recall if it was the exact match, but we're gonna work with this. You can actually use on top of your foundation, but I'm gonna use it under. Under is also a way to use it. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply it all over my skin, and I'm gonna work it with my fingers because I feel like this is gonna give it like a better finish. My hands have been washed, so they're good. So I have a big doe foot, which I like, and yeah, let's get started. I'm focusing it on my higher points. I'm putting a lot more on my higher points, the higher points of my face, because I do want that like very, very glowy finish there. I'm gonna go ahead and blend that out with my fingers. Okay, so I already blended it out. So this is the foundation, has a pump, perfect. So I'm gonna shake it up a little bit. Remember, it's very important for you to shake your foundation before, almost all products, it's important for you to shake every product before you use it. So I don't know how pigmented this foundation is because it's my first time trying it. So I'm gonna start with a little bit and then work it. So I'm gonna start with 2 pumps to see how that goes. So I'm just gonna pat it in and... Using a smaller brush is gonna take a little longer, but I like it. I like to like switch it up sometimes because I feel like it gives you more precision because of how small it is. And remember, I like to go over my foundation with a sponge. So far I've used that product on half of my face. A little more than half of my face, because I did my forehead too, like all of my forehead. But I'm gonna go in with a little bit more. So I think I'm gonna do like two more pumps. That's it. So that was perfect. Okay, so this is what our skin looks like after we've applied any foundation. I applied a total of 4 pumps. I like how it looks. I'm gonna go in with the sponge. I'm actually using a dose of color sponge, so I'm getting to try. And yeah, I'm just gonna blend that out. So I'm just doing tapping motion because I don't wanna take off the product that much. Actually really like it, and it does look very, very luminous. So I do want to make a little point out. This is a tutorial on like a luminous skin. I am trying out the Flawless filter because I heard it gives you a glowy finish, like it helps you glow. But this does not mean you have to use these exact same products. You can actually just do the before we did and just use the foundation that you have. And I'm pretty sure it's gonna give you a luminous effect. So in my case, like I said, I am using the Flawless filter. Sorry, the Hollywood Flawless filter. But you don't have to use these exact same products. I'm not telling you to go out and buy them, but I like them. I feel like it was worth it because I love a glowy skin. I'm very happy with the results so far. I'm gonna go ahead and add concealer. I don't have the Charlotte Tilbury concealer because trying out the product, but hey, you guys know that these products are pricey. So I don't have the concealer, so I decided to use the NARS concealer. This was in shade Custard Medium 1. So I'm gonna use this to conceal my eyes. And yeah, I decided to use this one because, I mean, it's not as high up there as Charlotte Tilbury's prices, but it's high up there. So yeah, I'm gonna use this one. Before this concealer, I normally like to apply it with my finger. And I tap it on, and then I'll blend it out with my finger, and then I'll blend it out a bit more with the beauty sponge. Now I'm gonna go ahead and blend that out with the sponge. Okay, so we're already done with our concealer. I do wanna contour out, like bronze up my skin a little bit, like yeah, define it a little bit, give it like that more chiseled look. Unfortunately, I don't have like a high-end product to cream contour, but I have one of my favorites, which is a drugstore. It's one of my favorites. We're gonna use this. So this is going to be like the exception. That's not gonna be high end. And this one's the Fit Me. It's in the shade Coconut. It's perfect. It's a cream contour. And like its name says it, it's very creamy. It blends out beautifully. So we're gonna do that to contour up our face and give us like a more chiseled look. So it looks something like this. Okay, and remember we wanna make it like thicker on top and it's gonna come down thinner. I'm gonna add a little bit over here. And we're adding a little bit up here because normally this is done to like make your forehead look smaller, but my forehead is smaller. So that's why I don't add that much. So I like to always start blending out the smaller things. So in this case, the smaller area that has contour is up here. So I'm gonna start up here. Tapping it in, and I'm bringing it in towards the hairline. And we're gonna go up. We're blending it out upwards. You can also do this with the foundation. You don't have to necessarily use like a cream contour stick. You can also do this with the foundation if you want, and it gives you a very natural finish. I also like to work with foundation. We already have a a very luminous skin, which is what we want. I'm very happy. I already contoured a bit, and I'm gonna like try to continue with all like this natural type of jazz. So I'm gonna go in with this Milk makeup. It's a like a lip oil and a cheek oil. So you can do this, you can use this for your lips and for your skin, and it's gonna give it like that tint color. So it's pretty sheer, which is good because we don't want to add too much color. I want to keep it like bronzy glowy. So we're going to blend that out with the sponge. Just tapping. Okay, so our skin is looking like this. I'm really happy with the way it looks. It looks luminous, which is what I like. And we're going to go ahead and set it. We're not going to use too much powder because we do want to keep that luminous effect. And I'm going to focus it mostly like underneath my eyes because my eyes do tend to crease easily. And I do have a lot of fine lines there. So I'm going in with this Morphe brush. This is the M438 brush. I'm just tapping it a little bit and I'm making sure I take off the excess. And I'm using the Hourglass powder, the veil powder. Okay, so as you guys can see, I set my under eye and it did give it like that matte finish, but I prefer to have like a matte finish underneath my eyes. I'm not gonna set the rest of my face because I do wanna keep that luminous glow. You could easily, with what you applied, the powder underneath your eye with that brush, with whatever you have left, like lightly tap it over like this. If you wanna set a little bit, but it's still gonna help you have like that glowy finish. Okay, so like I said, I'm gonna be leaving my skin like this. We're gonna go ahead and move on to highlighter. The highlighter that I'm gonna be using is from Laura Mercier. It's this one right here. It's in the shade Indiscretion. It's very beautiful. Look at this. Okay, so I'm going in with this highlighter brush. This is from Morphe. It's the M510 brush. And we're gonna be applying it on our high points. You guys know I love my highlight.
It doesn't matter if we're going for luminous skin. If my skin is already luminous, I wanna shine a little bit more. So I'm gonna add my highlighter.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and tap that in. Blend it in with the Balm Beauty Sponge. Very nice. I like the way it looks. I love a luminous, dewy skin. You guys know this. If you prefer matte, this is not for you. But yeah, I really like it. And we're gonna do the eyes now. I'm gonna go in with the Charlotte Tilbury eyeshadow palette. It's small, it has 4 shades. I'm just gonna use one of the shades. And then I'm gonna apply it all over, which is this one right here. This one is called Pop Scintillator, I think. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I'm gonna wet my brush. I'm gonna use this Max Fix Plus. Spritz it all over my brush. This one's the Morphe E17 brush. I'm gonna apply it all over the lid. I'm just gonna coat the brush. So with a clean brush, I'm gonna go ahead and blend that out. I'm gonna blend the edges out. Okay, so do you guys see the difference that it made blending out those edges? Look at this side and look at this side that the shadow is just like placed. Made a big difference, huh? Okay, and sadly, I did have a little bit of fallout. It was my fault because I did not apply powder underneath. So I'm just gonna brush it off. It wasn't something major, so that's fine. Okay, so we're done with the eyes and with the skin. We're just missing the mascara. I don't have a Charlotte Tilbury mascara, but I want to keep it fancy, and I'm going to use a Pat McGrath Labs mascara. Very pretty. Wow, that made my lashes look nice and long. Made our lashes look something like this. What do you guys think? And right now, the only thing we're missing is lip. I'm going to line my lips with this lip liner from Make Up Forever, and this is in the shade Whatever Walnut. I'm gonna go ahead and take off the lip balm that I have that was hydrating my lips so that I can apply the lipstick and the liner. After I applied my lip liner, I came back on camera and I swore I was recording, but I wasn't. So I applied my lipstick. I'm not gonna apply it again because I already applied. I'm gonna show you what I use. I use the Ciate London lipstick. This was in the shade Wanderlust. So I like the way it looks on my lips. I really like the shade. It's very pretty, perfect nude. I feel like it ties the look perfectly. And yeah, this is practically the finished look. I hope you guys like it. It's kind of what I consider would be perfect for like a date. I would use this with my angelito. So yeah, I love the way the skin looks. It looks very, very glowy. Like it's not too heavy. And yeah, I try to keep the tutorial as easy as possible so that it was understandable, it was easy to understand. Remember, you don't have to buy all these products. Like you don't have to go and buy the Hollywood Flawless filter. You can just use the steps that I showed you guys to achieve the glowy look, like with the moisturizer, the oil, the moisturizer, and adding a little bit of liquid illuminator. It's up to you, but like I said, if you don't like a dewy look, like a dewy luminous look, you're not gonna, like this tutorial isn't gonna be for you. Maybe you prefer more matte, but hey, everyone has their own taste. So that's fine with that. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. Make sure you share it. If you recreate this look, tag me on Instagram. My social media is going to be listed down below. My Instagram is going to be appearing down here right now. Editing Sasha, enter Instagram. Anyways, and then as I told you guys, I am also on TikTok now. So I'm going to put my TikTok because you guys are going to go ahead and check me out on TikTok. And yeah, with that being said, I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.